Listening Library presents Ginger and Petunia by Patricia Polacco. Read for you by Cassandra Campbell. Virginia Vincent Folsum is a very elegant lady. She lives in a scrumptious home in a very exclusive neighborhood. Ginger, as she is called, drives a snappy little red sports car, collects fine wines, and is a gourmet cook. But clothes, beautiful clothes, are her passion. "You are what you wear," she always says. She is also a brilliant pianist who gave up the stage to teach a dazzling array of musical prodigies. She accepts only the most promising young musicians. Her waiting list is endless. She hears her students from 7:30 in the morning until 5 o'clock in the afternoon. She listens, and listens, and listens. But the most astonishing thing about Ginger is Petunia, her pet pig. Petunia lives right in Ginger's house, just under the staircase next to the grand piano. Ginger does everything for Petunia. She cooks for her. She sews blankets for her and takes her for rides in her little red car. Ginger models every new outfit she buys for Petunia first. And practically every evening, they listen to grand opera together. Ginger even had a mud hole installed in her backyard just for Petunia. Of course, she built a lovely gazebo over the top of it and made it look like a spa. "My Petunia does so love her mud soaks," Ginger always says. One day, an engraved invitation arrived for Ginger all the way from England. "I've been invited to be the guest soloist at the International Congress of Pianists in London," Ginger trumpeted. Ginger was beside herself with excitement. "But I will have to leave for England tomorrow. And, oh dear, there's no food in the house. And a whole week of lessons will have to be rescheduled. And there's all of my social obligations. And you, Petunia, who is going to take care of you?" Ginger cried. In no time, Ginger called House Sitters, Inc. and arranged for someone to come and take care of Petunia and do everything on her to-do list. The next morning, it was time for Ginger to catch her flight.
"Well, my dear Petunia, I will miss you so very much," Ginger whispered as she kissed her pig's snout.
"Someone will be here within the hour to take care of you. I'll be back before you know it." Petunia watched as the cab left for the airport. The house was so empty. It was so quiet. This was the very first time.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.